Welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and in this particular video I will be talking about ANOVA. If you haven't watched my previous videos, please click on the I button on the top right hand side corner of your screen. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. ANOVA is a statistical technique which helps you compare samples from different populations and see if there is a difference of variation in both. For example, suppose that you have different varieties of seed and you want to compare the productivity of seed from each other and see that is there any difference when we change the quality of seed or not. Now, the essence of ANOVA is that the total amount of variation in a data set is broken down into two types. One is by chance, and the other is that is for a reason or is attributed to a cause. Which basically means that the variation in different quality the productivity of different quality of seeds can be because of the by chance element or because of any specified reason. So we want to check that if we take out different samples from the population and check for the productivity of different seeds, are we going to get the tiniest bit of changes are because of by chance element or it is because of some reason there. Now, ANOVA can be of two types. One is one-way ANOVA, and the second is two-way ANOVA. One-way ANOVA compares the data set based on only single factor. In our case, the example at which I previously gave you, the quality of seed is a single factor on the basis of which we are trying to measure the productivity and the difference in the productivity. When it comes to two-way ANOVA, there are two factors involved. One can be quality of seed . The other can be type of fertilizer . Now in this particular video I'll be discussing about one-way ANOVA. In my next video I'll be discussing about two-way ANOVA. So let's start. As I said, one-way ANOVA is based on a single factor. So suppose that we have a data set that is A, B and C, and these are three different qualities or kinds of seeds, you can say. Six, seven, three, and eight. We will also be discussing about the steps involved in calculating ANOVA here. But let me just give you a data set. 5, 5, 3, and 7, and the last but not the least 5, 4, 3, and 4. So the first step here is to calculate the mean of each seed productivity. So for that The first step is to calculate the mean. X bar. So for this particular column, type seed A, the mean will be 6. By the way, the formula of mean is nothing but this. So we add up all the elements of this and then we divide by the number of observations. So we get 6. In this column we get 5. And this column we get 4. Now the second step is to calculate the super mean. Now this is the term which I call it. You can call it anything else, but I call it super mean. So super mean means that 6 plus 5 plus 4 divided by the number of samples which we have, that is 3, we get 5 as our result, which can also be written as x double bar, and the single mean is x bar. Now the third step is to calculate the difference of the difference from each sample, the productivity difference between each sample. Okay, so for that we are going to use the formula. This is basically called SS between. So sum of squares between. Let me write it. Pura isko. Sum of squares between. We can also write it as SSB, and the formula to calculate that is N1, that is the number of observations in the first sample, X multiplied by X double bar, X bar minus X double bar whole square plus N2 and the same formula will repeat, that is x bar minus x double bar. Here mean of each column we are talking about, so that's it, and so on and so forth. So in this particular formula, let's put the data. So we have, for this we have 4 samples for 6 mean minus 5, that was our double bar, okay, ka square plus 4, 5 minus 5 square plus 4, 4 minus 5 ka whole square. And the end result would be 4 plus 0 plus 4, that is 8. I'm going to write it here. So the x bar, these are the x bar, and x double bar is 5. And in this case, SS between, that is SSB, is 8. Now our next step would be, to calculate SS within, sum of squares within. So this particular formula also, ANOVA also helps us to understand the variations within the sample and then compare it with the variations between the samples as well. So that is what we are going to do. We are going to understand the variation in the sample within the sample, and then we are going to also understand what is the variation between the sample when we are changing samples to samples, right? So for SS within, the formula would be summation x 1i plus x bar 1 square plus summation x 2i minus x bar 2 whole square and so on and so forth. So in this regards, our data value will be, let's consider first part only. So this, let's take it for A. So it will be 6 minus 6 whole square plus 7 minus 6 whole square plus 3 minus 6 whole square plus 8 minus 6 whole square. So we get, for this we get 0 plus 1 plus 9 plus 4 equals to 40. Same thing goes for B. I'm going to write the direct results. You can just click, you can just apply this formula only. So again, 5 minus 5 ka whole square plus 5 minus 5 ka whole square plus 3 minus 5 ka whole square and 7 minus 5 ka whole square. So the result would be 8 in this case, and so on and so forth. I'm writing the C result directly, and that is 2. Okay, so now all we need to do is add 14 plus 8 plus 2, and we get 24 as our result. So SS within is 24. Now again, I'm going to remove this entire thing so that further steps can be followed on the same page. Now, the next thing to do is, I'm going to write it in green only, so it's quite highlighting. So the next step is to calculate MS mean squared between now how to calculate mean squared between we write SSB upon K minus 1. Okay, so for MS between, the SSB is 8, and what is K? K is nothing but the number of samples which we have. So it would be 8, K is 3 minus 1, so that will be 8 upon 2. The end result will be 4 here. And likewise, we are also going to calculate MS within. So for that again, we will be taking MS within . So basically here what we are doing is we are considering the degree of freedom, so that even if the data is a single observation, few observations are high, we are able to somewhere reduce the error which might happen. Yeah, so for MS within, again SSW upon N minus K. here n minus k is the n is number of observations. So total number of observation is 4, 4, 8, 12. So SS within is 24 upon 12 minus k, that is k is 3, that is the number of samples. So we have 24 divided by 9. The end result will be 2.6. So MS between is 4 and MS within is 2.6. Okay, now all we need to do is calculate the F ratio. And the formula for F ratio will be MS between upon MS within, right? So MS between is 4 and MS within is 2.6. So we get a result as 1.53 in my case. It can be different in your case based on the decimals you have taken. So don't worry if my result and your result doesn't match. It should be closer to this value. Okay, so that's that. Now the only thing left here is to find out the critical value from the F distribution table to check when whether this 1.3 is a by chance variation or it is because of some reason. So here on the screen you can see that the F distribution table with the level of significance considered as 5%, and we need to calculate, or we will need to find out the critical value on the basis of k minus 1 and n minus k, whereas this will be vector 1 and this will be vector 2. Okay, so we k minus 1, that is 3 samples minus 1 is 2, so here we have 2 value, and n minus k, that is 12 minus 3, that is 9. So in this regards we have this 9 here. So all we need to do is match this with this, and we got a result as 4.26. Now what we are going to do is we are going to draw a graph, and we are going to see whether or not four point two six here. This is from the negative side, this is the positive side. This is the rejection region, this is the acceptance region. Just revising, getting your revision here. The symbol for this space is 1 minus alpha, and this is alpha 2, alpha this, and the value is 1.53, that lies within the boundaries of the critical value. So we can say somewhere here 1.53. in this case we can now say that there is no difference between the different productivity of different quality of seeds, just because the result lies within the boundaries of the critical value. So the little bit of difference which we see is because of the by chance element and not because of any reason here. Now I would like to go through the steps of ANOVA once again to make you understand what actually happened here. So initially what we did is we calculated the the mean values, and then we also calculated the super mean. Now SS between samples compares the variation of one sample to the variation of other sample, right? We compare the variation here and calculate the SSB. So this much amount of variation is there within the between the samples. Now we since we are comparing the data, we also need to consider the variations within the sample. So that is why we have calculated SS within. You can just go ahead and go to the beginning of the video and check out the formula for the same. So the within the sample variation is 24 here. Now what we are doing is there might be a situation there where the data could be higher than 8, that it can be 15 or it can be 13 or at anything. So for that reasons we have considered the degree of freedom, so that any changes may not have a larger effect on the samples and the result because of any random changes. So that is why we have calculated the mean square between and mean square within samples. So within the samples, if that happens, then also we have considered that, and in case of between samples, we have also considered that. At last, what we have done is, if you remember, the hypothesis testing F distribution has a formula like this, right? For comparing the variations. So in this case also we are doing a similar thing, but instead we are using MSB and MS within instead. So scratching this from the hypothesis testing, now we are comparing it on the basis of different factors, applying the same formula but it's in a slightly different way, and hence we get a result of 1.53, which is the end result, that is the F ratio, similar to the hypothesis testing F ratio. And all we need to do is compare the result, find out the critical value based on the significance level. In this case we had 5% of significance level. You can go ahead and try it with 1% of significance level and then check the result changes or not. In that case, if you do that, please comment the result or comment any problems you have in your data set or while solving this entire thing. I'll be happy to provide you with the solutions. So on this note, thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Please click on the bell icon if you want to stay updated on my posts. If you want to learn more from DexLab Analytics or from me, you can go to the website www.dexlabanalytics.com or call on the given numbers given on the screen. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. Also, you can mail us at the rate hello@dexlabanalytics.com. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. Take care.